My name is Casey Schmidt. I am a third year graduate student in the curriculum in genetics and molecular biology at UNC-Chapel Hill. What I do, I work in a lab, and we work specifically on non-coding RNAs, and my whole family, no one's a scientist, but I grew up watching Bill Nye the Science Guy and the Magic School Bus. So that's how I got into science. I always loved watching those. Started the science club in third grade, in grade school. Always liked it, tried to do science fair projects, things like that in high school. And then by the time I got to college, it just kind of made sense to choose a biology major. Wanting to find out how the world works and how things happen, is fascinating, and that's kind of how I see myself now. I'm just immensely curious about how basic biological systems work, and it's kind of like it's trying to solve a puzzle. And that's what one of the things I really love about science is that you need to be kind of creative too, and a lot of people don't realize that. So you know, you've got a problem, you're trying to find an answer. Sometimes you got to be creative and think of a really cool experiment to solve the problem and to find your answer. When you think about the central dogma of molecular biology, it's DNA to RNA to protein, and everyone sees RNA as just the intermediate between DNA and protein, just passive something in the middle. We don't know if it has a function. We think it does. So if we can show that there's this new type of RNA and it's doing something, that's really exciting. This is an incubator where we keep our cells. So we got a couple different kinds in here. And this is an inverted microscope that lets us see the cells on the plate. And so we just like to check and see what they look like and see if they're growing well. They're really understudied, and we're really trying to figure out what their role is, and you know, there's some speculation on what they're doing. And if we've got a really cool system to study, that will really impact the circular RNA field as well. And then what I'll do is label it with the cell type, and then the dilution that I split them at, and then I'll do the same for both. And then I will stick them back in the incubator. And so the incubator will keep them warm and keeps their pH at a normal level. I also grow fly cells. So these are called S2 or Schneider 2 cells. They're nice and cloudy, which means lots of cells are growing. So if I just give the flask a gentle tap, I can see lots and lots of cells. So these cells are a glioblastoma. They're taken from a brain cancer in the 1950s. So this is quite an old cell line. And then I'm also working with a different cell line, which is a glioblastoma. So it's came from a brain cancer. These ones are growing just fine, so we like to passage them and split them into new plates. So this media has got growth factors, and then it's got some antibiotics to make sure that nothing bad will grow in the media. And so what we're trying to do now is to hack that system, and if we can replace a tRNA intron with any sort of gene that we want and make our own designer circle, like that's really cool. That's a new way to make circular RNAs. And the methods to make circular RNAs, like in vivo and the cell now, they're pretty few and far between. And this one, it seems to be pretty reliable. It's based on a conserved system, so it's really exciting. I'm usually growing up cells and cell culture, and so I'll come in and check on those and make sure they haven't died on me. These cells are adherent, which means that they kind of cling on to the plastic, and we use an enzyme called trypsin to get them up off the plate. This is a solution of cells and media. So I'm just mixing it up nicely and put it into new plates. And then usually I like to manipulate those cells by transfection or something like that. And so I'll do that sort of experiment, and then a couple days later, I'll extract the RNA from those cells and then analyze it by a gel. This is just what we call splitting cells, passaging them, letting them grow. There's usually always people around, someone to talk to or bounce ideas off of. And really great to make an impact on the RNA field, and I think that our work with these circular RNAs really might do that. And bringing attention to RNA, because like I said, it's the underdog, you know, that's kind of how I see RNA. But being able to bring RNA research to the forefront would be really exciting. So it's important to remember, don't give up, because things are not gonna work in the lab. You're gonna come in some days and it's 9:30 in the morning and this experiment didn't work and that experiment didn't work, and you just wanna lay on the floor and say, I give up for today. So just don't give up, because when things don't work, there's usually a reason why something doesn't work, and just keep going at it, keep trying, try different things, talk to people, talk to your lab mates, to your PI, try to figure out what's going on, and that way, when it does work, because it will work, it's that much better.